In this example, we're going to look at the case of a CSTR, an exothermic reaction. And we did experimental measurements where we varied the inlet temperature, T0, and we measured then the reactor temperature at steady state. As we increased the inlet temperature, the reactor temperature did not change much until we reached the ignition point. Then there was a large increase in temperature, where now we have high conversion, and then increasing inlet temperature caused up here a slight increase in temperature. When we reversed the process and cooled down, we didn't follow the same pathway, but we cooled down to a lower temperature. Then the temperature exhibited a sharp drop, and then it changed gradually with the feed temperature until it exhibited another sharp drop, and we got back to our initial conditions. And so what we want is, what are the solutions, what's referred to as the bifurcation diagram. And essentially what we're looking at is that we have some temperature time relation from those diagrams that goes up until we reach some ignition point, and we get this sharp jump in temperature. We'll look at it from the other way. We're going to go down until we get this jump in temperature, so this curves back. Now, we don't know exactly how far, but we know it's less than the temperature here, or we see that in when we heat it up. And then we have another one, and then the details, of course, we don't know, but we do know there are these points where we get these changes, sharp changes in temperature, where all these are possible solutions, but we only can reach the stable solutions by this process. And again, the details are not correct. This is just an approximate plot here. But this demonstrates all the solutions then to the material and energy balances that could result in this behavior we observe in the laboratory. In this second problem, we're looking at an adiabatic CSTR. We're given initial conditions. We're not at steady state yet. We want to know, does the temperature increase or decrease from these initial values? And we're given the various parameters for the system. And so what we want to look at is the energy balance to determine whether temperature increases or decreases. To do that, I'm going to write it in terms of a density, a mass heat capacity, and a volume. So that's the reactor contents mass and then the heat capacity. Change in temperature with time. What's going to change because we have reaction. And then it's going to change because we have flow in. Density times volumetric flow rate is mass flow rate. A mass heat capacity, feed temperature minus the reactor temperature. Well, we can substitute in numerical values here. I've substituted in the values. Keep in mind now the units of the rate constant, seconds to the minus 1. This is minus KCA here. I put in the starting temperature in the system, and I put in the starting concentration. These are the conditions that we want to know whether the temperature increases or decreases. We put in consistent units. This is moles per centimeter cubed, this is centimeter cubed. And then likewise in the second term, this is the feed, and this is the initial temperature in the reactor, and now the volumetric flow rate and heat capacity and density in the appropriate units. So if I just do the calculations for these numbers, the first term is positive, the second term is negative. So overall, this derivative times the heat capacity terms. But what we're interested in is the sign. So the derivative of the temperature respect to time is greater than zero. So that says for these starting conditions, the temperature increases.